Started in section 8.5, inequalities and systems of inequalities in two variables. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to try to kind of lump together in this one section what would have probably taken a whole chapter in your Algebra 2 class. But we're going to start off with the simplest of the linear inequalities in two variables. Now, we've done inequalities in single variables where we'd have like x is greater than 5 and we'd graph on the number line. Well, with two variables, we need two number lines, and as you can see on the screen, I have all sorts of sets of coordinate axes already set up to use for graphing our solutions, because linear inequalities don't have single answers. Just like inequalities in one variable, inequalities in two variables have typically infinitely many answers, and so the best way to represent that would be with a graph. So linear inequality in two variables is any inequality in the form ax plus by less than c, where both a and b are not equal to 0, and instead of less than, you could have a greater than, a less than or equal to, or greater than or equal to can be used. Now, the steps are not that difficult, because if we had equality, we would have the graph of a line. Ax plus by equals c would be the standard form of the equation of a line. So it is this key line, this boundary line, that we were going to find, and then we're going to use that to determine where our solutions lie. So the steps would be, first, we're going to graph the related equation. We're going to change this inequality to an equation, and then we're going to graph that line. Now, when we graph the line, do we want the line as part of our answer? Well, if it has the equal to, that means we want the answers for the ordered pairs of the points on the line as part of our solution set. If it doesn't have the equal to, then we don't, and we represent that with a dotted line. Now, you may remember back in maybe like an Algebra 1 class where you would graph on a number line and you would have an open circle or a filled in circle. Well, this is kind of like our filled in circle, and this is kind of like our open circle. This is kind of like in interval notation, the bracket, and this is more like the parenthesis. Now, once we have found that boundary line from the related equation, we've got to determine to which half plane, because the line will divide the Cartesian plane into two half planes. We have to decide which half plane is going to have our solution, because that's the nice thing about this. The boundary line separates the answers from those that are not answers. So we have to determine that, and we'll use a test point, and I'm going to show you how to do that. And of course, we'll represent, just like on a number line, we shaded to one side of our key value. Well, we're going to shade to one side of our boundary line. So here's a very simple example. I'm going to graph this solution set, 4x minus y is greater than 3. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to write this as an equation. So I have 4x minus y is equal to 3. I'm going to kind of manipulate this around so that I can put this in slope-intercept form, because I find it easier to graph a line in slope-intercept form. And to do that, I'm going to probably add y to both sides and subtract 3 from both sides. And I'm going to get y is equal to 4x minus 3, unless I've made a silly mistake there. So let me check my work. I think that looks all right. My y-intercept is at 0, negative 3. My slope is 4, which is the same as 4 over 1. So down here on this set of axes that I've drawn out, notice the arrows on the ends of the axes. I see that a lot, that you guys don't like to put the arrows on the ends of axes. Always put those to represent that these are number lines. And of course, always set your scale on the x-axis and the y-axis. So my y-intercept, again, my slope here is 4. My y-intercept is 0, negative 3. So I'll graph 0, negative 3 down here. My slope is 4, so that's up 4 to the right 1. Now I have the two points that are gonna that I'm gonna use to graph my boundary line from this related equation here. Now, do I want to include the values that are on the line? Because the values that are on the line is where it's equal. Well, I don't want where it's equal. There's no equal to here as there would be if I use one of these symbols. So I am going to represent this with a dotted line. Now I have a yardstick right here. For those of you that have never seen a yardstick before, I'm going to line that up best I can. Now because I'm graphing on the whiteboard here, I'm not going to probably have as much accuracy as if I was, yardstick slid a little bit there, as I would have on a graph paper, but I think that's probably enough to represent the boundary line that separates this half plane here that's kind of up and to the left and this half plane here that's kind of down and to the right. One of these half planes has all the solutions, the other half plane does not. So what we're going to do is we have to determine what side to shade. That's what I'm talking about here. We're going to pick a test point. And I can relate this. When my daughters were little, every once in a while I would take them down to the good old Rebel gas station convenience store, and they would have hot dogs and soft drinks for 99 cents. That's how old I am. And I would have my daughters get their drinks. One would ask for Pepsi and one would ask for Dr. Pepper. Well, they looked the same. You put the caps on and in the similar looking cups, you take them to the counter to pay for them, and sometimes you could get them mixed up. You wouldn't know which one was which. So the easiest way to tell was to put a straw in one of them and take a sip, a test sip. And if that test sip was Pepsi, and that's the one that my daughter that took the sip wanted, then she would say, this one's mine, the other one's my sister's. And if it wasn't, then of course you go, oh, this is my sister's, the other one's mine. And then of course the little sister would cry, oh, she tasted it already, she got her germs in it. So what we're going to do here is we're going to take a test sip. We're going to take a test point. My favorite test point to use is 0, 0. You can use any point you want, it just can't be a point on this dotted line, because that's where we have equality. We have to see where it makes the inequality true. So I take a point, not on the line, and I like 0, 0. I like 0, 0 a lot because it's easy to do arithmetic when you plug zeros in. And I go back to the original problem, and I substitute 0, 0, my test point, which is on this half plane, back into here. So 0 and 0 in for x and y, respectively. Do I get a true statement? Well, all of this is 0, 0 is not greater than 3. So 0, 0, which again is in this half plane here, makes it false. That means every one of these is going to make it false. That means, by process of elimination, this half plane down here has the solutions. Now if you don't, you know, trust me, take a point, any point down here. Let's say, for example, I took the point 4, 0 and I plugged 4 and 0 in. You would see I would get a true statement. So I'm going to represent all this half plane by shading, and what I like to do is I try to draw what looks like parallel lines here to represent that I'm shading this part of the half plane in. Don't just do one of these things on one side. That doesn't really represent the entire half plane. I know it does in your head, but it doesn't when somebody's looking at it that's grading it. So make sure that you pick a test point. 0, 0 is great. Again, it cannot be on the line. So if I have a line that goes through 0, 0, I got to pick a different point. And then plug back into the original to see if it makes it true or false. If it makes it true, you shade in the side with the test point. And in this case, when it makes it false, you shade in the opposite half plane, the opposite side of the line. So I have up here, I have three more examples, very similar. I'm going to run through these kind of quickly. I have a couple special cases here. You notice that I just have single variables in these two inequalities, but we'll get to those here in just a second. So I'll do A right here, and I have 2y is greater than or equal to 5x. Now I'm going to write the related equation, 2y equals 5x. I'm going to put it in slope-intercept form by dividing by 2. And I get the line y equals 5 halves x. So my slope is 5 halves, my y-intercept is 0. So it's going to contain the origin. I can't use it at that one as a test point now. And my slope is 5 halves, so from the y-intercept up 5 to the right 2. And again, graph paper is so much better than me just kind of freehanding it here. Now, because I have the 2 points and I'm ready to graph the line, I've got to check my inequality to see if it indeed includes the points on the line. And because of the equal to, I want to include the points on the line. So again, I get a ruler out, or some kind of straight edge, ask me if I have a ruler. Do I have a ruler? Yes, my wife. Okay, here we go. Let me graph this. All right. Now, I'm either shading in this half plane or this half plane. So I pick a point, not on the line. I can't use 0, 0. Why don't I pick something simple? How about 1, 0? 1, 0 would be an easy one to plug in. And it's on this side of the line. So I'll plug 1, 0 in. 1 in for x and 0 in for y. So going back to the original, I didn't give myself a lot of extra space here. This would be 2 times 0 is greater than or equal to 5 times 1. So I get 0 is greater than or equal to 5, which is false, just like it was false over here, it's false here. So 1, 0, which was on this side of the half plane, makes it false. So by process of elimination, I want the other half plane. So I'm going to shade on this side and try to be neat. Now, if you put your pencil kind of on its side and you go to blacken it in, usually it just smears, and then heaven forbid you discover you accidentally shaded the wrong half plane, then it's a real mess to have to clean up. So you're better off doing something like this. Some people will use colored pencils, and that's great. That makes it easy to spot. All right, this half plane has infinitely many ordered pairs, and they're all, or infinitely many points that are represented by ordered pairs that are all solutions to this inequality up here. Now we'll do B over here. My related equation is 2y equals 3, or y equals 3 halves, and that is on the Cartesian plane, that is a horizontal line. It is a horizontal line that goes through 0, 3 halves, or 0, 1 and a half right here. So I'm going to draw a horizontal line, but I have to go back to the original problem to determine if it's a solid or a dotted. No equal to, so it's dotted. I'm going to freehand this one. I would suggest that you use a ruler, but this graph isn't very big. And I'm going to represent that horizontal line with that dotted line right there. And now I'm either going to shade below or I'm going to shade above. Well, with a less than and the variable on the left side, you probably have a pretty good guess, but I'll take a test point. 0, 0, I'll go back to the original. I'm going to put it right here because I'm running out of space. 0 in for x and y, well, it's only in for y, so it'd be 2 times 0 is less than 3. 0 is less than 3 is true. So since 0, 0 was below the boundary line here, I'm going to shade below. Try to be neat. And there's my solution set. At least that's the graphical representation of my solution set to the inequality 2y is less than 3. One more to go here. Let's try part C here. X is greater than or equal to 9/4. Now, the related equation would be x is equal to 9/4. And you know that this is a special type of line. This is a vertical line. And the vertical line would go through 9/4, or on the x-axis would go through where the x is 9/4, which is 2 1/4, so I'm going to approximate it about here. It is going to be a vertical line through that point. It is going to be a solid because of the equal to vertical line. So again, probably should get the straight edge out. I'm just going to try to be as neat as I can there, which wasn't all that great. I can do better, I hope. A little better. And I have two half planes to the right and to the left of my boundary line. I pick 0, 0 as my test point, go back to here, plug in 0 for x, because that's the only variable, and I have a false statement. So 0, 0, which was on this half plane, on this side of my boundary line, makes it false. Therefore, I want to shade the other half plane. Okay? It either is or it isn't. When you take that test point, it either makes it true or it makes it false. If it makes it false, you want the other half. If it makes it true, you want the half that you took it from. And what we're going to do now is we're going to continue with this. We're going to look at systems when we have two or more, and we're also going to look at inequalities in two variables that are not linear. So we may get some parabolas or some circles or something like that. So we've got plenty more to study here.